I love background music. Like, I pick my own songs for a reason. They set the tone, they carry the vibe, but I also love clear vocal sounds. And I hate sometimes that it feels like I have to choose. Either I hear the music or I hear my voice, but never both, which is the way that I want it to be. So I basically called one of my good friends, Dave. I've known him for years and he's an absolute legend when it comes to audio. And he honestly showed me something that kind of blew my mind. Okay, bro, Dave, please explain this trick that you showed me years ago in Adobe Premiere Pro, because when you first did it, I didn't even understand what I was hearing.
Right, so here's the deal. Instead of lowering your music so your voice can cut through, what you want to do is create room for your voice, not volume-wise, but in the frequency spectrum. Now, in Premiere Pro, you add a de-esser, but not to your voice, to the music. And then you go in, edit the range so it hits around 2 to 5K. That's where most of your vocal clarity sits. Now, when your voice is playing over the music naturally sits in that pocket you've created in just those frequencies. You don't necessarily hear the music get quieter, but your voice just becomes a lot clearer. You can also pair that up, if you want to, with some light auto tucking around 2 dB.
Let's walk through this real quick here in Adobe Premiere Pro. So, I've got a voice track, as you can see, and I've got music underneath. So here we are in Premiere Pro. Let's take a quick listen at this sound mix. Okay, obviously, this sounds horrible. The background music is way too loud. The first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna go over to effects, and then we're gonna type in de-esser into the search. We're then gonna bring the de-esser effect over onto the music. After that, we're gonna go to effects controls, and we're going to edit the de-esser effect. This is going to bring an entire range of all the frequencies present. What we're gonna do then is we're gonna take these, you can call them in and out points maybe, and drag them so that they basically carve out a huge pocket right in the middle of all of these frequencies. We know that our voice, that's me talking, is gonna lay within these frequencies, probably around here. So what we're doing is we're essentially gonna carve out all of these frequencies out of the music so that our voice can lay comfortably within this pocket and theoretically allow me not to have to actually lower the volume of the music that much in order for me to hear my voice. All right, let's play it through one more time. I want to say again, I have not changed the volume of the music and I have not changed the volume of my voice at all. I just basically carved out the frequencies that my voice usually lies in and that theoretically any voice lies in out of my music. Let's play through it.
Underneath. First step, drop a de-esser onto the music. Then open up the edit tab and set the frequency to around 3 to 5K.
That sounds way better, but obviously it's not quite perfect. What I would do here is you could either just end up lowering the gain of your music or maybe raising up the gain of your voice just so that your voice cuts through a little bit better. But this is what I actually love to do before I even think about doing that. This extra garnish that I'm gonna actually apply to the voice this time is an extra secret that we haven't even talked about yet. It's gonna involve us adding an audio effect to the entire track that my voice is in, as opposed to the specific clips like we usually do. Go to Window and make sure that Audio Track Mixer is checked. Then go over to the sequence that you're in. We're in test. Go to the caret within your audio track mixer and make sure you bring it down. Then note the track that we're going to be working with. So our voice is currently in the track A2. Scroll down to make sure. A2, that's going to be the second column here. And we're going to go down to amplitude and compression. And then we're going to add a multi-band compressor. Next, we're gonna click on this, double click. Then we're gonna go to presets and we're gonna go to broadcast. That's the broadcast preset. We're then gonna go to margin and we're gonna bring that down to -3. This limiter prevents your audio from ever going above -3, basically preventing your audio from clipping. The last thing we're gonna do is we're actually going to increase the gain, but we wouldn't have to increase it as much as we normally would. So let's increase it to like say 8 decibels. We'll then exit out and play through it.
And I've got music underneath. First step, drop a de-esser onto the music. Then open up the edit tab, then set the frequency to around 3 to 5K. Then adjust the threshold a bit until it sounds clean. Now hit play. You'll hear the music.
What I'm then gonna do is I'm gonna lower the volume of the music, let's say just by like negative 12.
Let's walk through this real quick here in Adobe Premiere Pro.
That sounds so much better.
Shout out to my boy Dave for putting me on. This trick has literally changed the way that I mix audio. Please try it in your next video. You will never go back.